Hello everyone, SP Architects here. In today's tutorial, I'm going to show you how to make whole building from elevation. Sometimes you get plans from somewhere, and as you all know, it's quite easy to model it up with ARCHICAD because you have plans. You can just put them inside in ARCHICAD and set up as reference or underlay to floor plans and just model. But in this video tutorial, we don't have any plans. We only have elevations. In order to do that, we are going to follow another way. It's quite easy and I know that you know this technique from your architectural school. Yes, we are going to use that one. Alright, any further ado, let's get into the tutorial. Alright, here we are in ARCHICAD and we are going to import our reference images first. Let's go to File menu, External Contents and click the Place External Drawing. Here we have two additional elevation. And we are going to import both, Place External Drawing and the second one, click Open. Let's look at the unit system. As we can see here, it uses feet metric system. So let's change our working units at the project preferences, and from the working units we are going to change this meter to this feet and decimal inches and click OK. Now we can work this file. And for instance, hit M button and measure this one. It's 2 feet and 10 inches. So we have to fix this and align to 3 feet. We are going to click this PDF file and also this one. Hit Ctrl plus K, click OK. Click the center of the line and this center point of the line and input here 3 and enter. Let's check it out from another part. For instance, we have 8 feet here. Measure this one. And as you can see here, it's 8. So we can continue. At the very first, I'm going to duplicate this PDF files and click one of edges and trim also this one. After that, we are going to do reverse. There we go. Now we are going to align these elevations to our working area. For instance, let's start from front elevation and place here. And as for the back, this one. But not like this. We have to rotate this 180 degrees. And this is right elevation. So we are going to rotate this side. And also, this is going to be rotated 90 degrees. There we go. After doing that, we are going to use reference line. We have this reference line at the top part of the ARCHICAD and also from the left part. In order to place this one, we are going to click this line and drag and to our destination position and also from the right part to here. There we go. In order to change this reference line location, we have this circle here and we can click this one and drag and drop to anywhere we want. Also, it was appeared right here. Appears near the mouse, as you can see. Therefore, we can easily change the location. After that, I'm going to place this one to this reference line. And as you can see here, it was placed its original location. And from the top part, let's just click this edge and place to here. Also this one. Okay, now create another reference line to here, to the building, and also this edge. Also we have here. We can add another one for terrace or deck, whatever. This is for deck, and also to this part, to the brick. After placing our reference line, we are going to place our floor. But before that, we need a thickness for that. Hit the M button and from here to here, it's 6 inches. Now, actually we can directly measure up the any dimension we want because we will fix this to proper scale. So let's change the structure and change this one to 6 inches. Hit enter.
Now, let's just start from this corner and make the polygonal. And to here, we have a corner here, turn to right, and to here, we have a ball actually, and go to down to this corner. Yeah, it's the same, it will be the same because it's symmetrical. And complete the floor. And also we have a terrace. There we go. Now the hardest part was completed. We can continue by adding walls. We are going to hit the spacebar and hover over the slab and click. After that we are going to split this from here because we have a height variation from this part, as you can see. As for this part, the height will be 15 feet and 10 inches. So let's click our wall and change the wall height by hitting Ctrl plus T, not linked from here. It was 15 and 10. Click OK. And as for this one, it's going to be 10 feet. Click this wall and this and this and input here 10. Not there. To here. Click not linked. Input here 10. And click OK. Actually, we are going to get rid of this one and intersect. Or maybe we don't have to intersect because we don't know the floor plan. We don't know the floor plan of the building. Therefore, we are going to change this height as 10. Also, I want to add here another wall. Let's change this to line. Because we have a roof here and the roof will be sit on this wall. Okay, now we can add our roofs. And while adding roofs, we have this eaves overhang. And as for that, it's 1 feet and 6 inches for the geometry method. We are going to click this mood plane. And for the structure, let's just go with the simples. And click this offset, input here 1 and 6. After that, we are going to click this corner and close from this corner. After that, let's click the roof we created and click this top part of the roof. And we have stretch and we are going to stretch to here and also to here. Now we are going to make the second roof. In order to achieve that, we are going to make ordinary roof like this one. In order to change the roof edge angle, we are going to click this one, make straight, and for the thickness, we input here 6 inches, and change the height elevation of the roof. Once we have done that, we are going to change the pitch angle. Let's just click the top point of the roof, click the node, click this one, and align the corner, and also this one. But as you can see here, there are something wrong with the roof orientation. So Ctrl plus Z, go to floor plan and rotate the roof like this. Align to building, stretch to the walls. We are going to align the edges of the roofs. By the way, in order to see the precisely, we are going to change the roof cover from this menu. Click this one and uncheck this cover fills. Once this is done, we can change the pitch point of the roof easily. And also, we are going to make this flat. We are going to intersect these roofs together. So we use line helpers. Let's click the line and connect to this corner. There we go. And now we can fix the height of this bottom roof. Here we have problem after doing that at the corners. We have to fix that manually. In order to do that, we just click the edge of the roof and click the offset edges. We are kinda going to trim by this method and intersect these edges at the correct position manually. Let's click this one also. And maybe more inside. Once this is done, we are going to place our windows and doors from the window tool. Let's click this simplest one. we have no sash here. After correcting right dimensions, we are going to place them next to our reference image. Once we have done one of these, we are going to mirror it from the center of the roof. There we go. Now we can make our entrance door. Let's take the measurements. It's 6 feet and 5 inches, 8 feet 5. We're gonna go to door tool. We're gonna select HV grid. After setting properties, we are going to duplicate and duplicate to other side. Since we have used a couple of doors to make exterior casing for this one, we are just going to use the shell tool and change its material. For garage doors, we are going to use custom doors and save it as an object. There we have our garage doors, and by this method, we can do whatever we want. We can also change its size settings. For the deck columns, we are just going to use column and change its sizes. Place to here. After doing that, we are going to add some additional segments and turn into fixed size, so we can directly input a length or height here. If not, ArchiCAD will use percentages. After setting up final adjustments, we are going to click OK and place the corner. Go to 3D, and there we have the same column with the original PDF file. For the deck beams, of course we are going to use beam tool, place the correct position and change values. After doing that, we are going to change the end part of the beam, slant angle. Let's make this flat and extend to the roof. It seems like this in the 3D. Let's go to floor plan, and we are going to copy rotate from the center, and we are going to do the same for the other columns. Copy, drag and place the right position. After doing that, we are going to mirror from the middle. Maybe we may need to fix the correct position. After adding columns, we are going to fulfill the deck floor also to the other side. After making this, you can add some wooden railings for the deck. We have a star here. In order to model like these objects, I prefer using lines and circles in order to use it as a sketch. And we fulfill the inside with the slab tool. In this stage, we can change its material settings. Let's go with metal and click OK. Hit the spacebar and click and duplicate. Offset inside. Select the bigger circle. Click the subtract polygon and hit spacebar, click the inside. And delete the inner part. As for the star part, I prefer using shell tool. After adding the shell, I'm going to change the thickness to 1 inch. And in the 3D window, we are going to change the curves to the lines. After that, we are going to change the elevation of the points. Once we've done that, let's change the override surfaces to the same metal. Click OK and mirror like this and copy along the whole circle. There we have our wall star. Now we can place this one to the wall. In order to do that, we are going to turn this into morph object. I'm gonna add wall lamps to the deck. I have used ArchiCAD own library for that, but of course you can use custom objects and use other libraries. I have a video about that and gonna add in the description. This is the final stage of the building that we have done this together. I just wanted to explain all stages quite clear, but it was very long. Therefore, I have cut into the pieces. But if you want to see all of the stages, I am going to add that into my Patreon page. Therefore, you will see the whole stages. Okay guys, that was pretty much it for this video tutorial. I hope you have enjoyed this one. Please like and share. Do not forget to subscribe. And also, if you want to reach this project file as well as my other project files, you can just check them out in my Patreon page. Until next time, have a nice day.